So cold open here, since obviously you can see a bunch of Voltron toys. You know, normally if I'm gonna do a video about a show besides Power Rangers, I'd maybe sing the theme song, but the theme song is just instrumental for Voltron, so da 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 da. Yeah, see, I got nothing. Anyway, let's start this dog and pony show. Okay, folks, I am Jeremy, aka Captain Subpar, sitting behind all these boxes. And again, obviously, I have a very interesting unboxing for us this week. Excuse me. Funny thing is, Voltron is one of those shows that I think is very comparable to Power Rangers. Let me slide this back here so you can see my beautiful, gorgeous face. Now, I don't know about you, but when I was a kid, and I was loving Power Rangers, I had a friend of my older brother who would tell me, you know, like, oh, Power Rangers is stupid. It's just a ripoff of Voltron. And for me, that's what actually got me to go online, do some research, and figure out that, oh, shows like Voltron and Gatchaman are actually shows that were based off of Super Sentai, which existed a long time ago. You know, and I use that information, I go rub it in people's faces and say, you know, Power Rangers is a lot older than all this other stuff, it's cool, blah, 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 whatever. But the cool thing is that it did actually lead me to do the research and understand the history of Power Rangers and Super Sentai in general. So when I heard they were rebooting Voltron, I was kind of excited. I knew it was the same people that did Avatar, The Last Airbender, and The Legend of Korra, two shows I love. And yes, I watched some old Voltron, and I realized, like a lot of shows from the 80s, like Transformers and He-Man, that they don't really hold up. They're not that great of shows. They're very formulaic, like Power Rangers. But I love them nonetheless. And the good thing to say about Voltron is that, you know, season one came out very early. Actually it came out on my birthday last year. Season one of Voltron hit. And now season two is hitting 6 months later. As of the recording of this video, it actually aired, it hit Netflix yesterday. And I watched the whole thing and I'm just loving this show. Both seasons, fantastic. There's a lot more to come. And now we have toys coming out. And there's some basic figures for like the different lions, there's smaller versions, and they're gonna actually make the pilots, which is great and all that. But what I wanted was the big boys, because this is where you can actually combine and form Voltron. Now this is a pricey endeavor. The four lions by themselves are 18 bucks a pop at Target where I got them, while the black lion is $30. So, you know, combined, you are looking at, you're looking at nearly $100 to get the entirety of Voltron. So that's a big commitment, much like the 5-in-1 Power Rangers movie Megazord I showed you earlier in another video. You know, that's a lot of money. So I'm here, you know, just unbox these, tell you what I think of them, just gush about Voltron in general, you know, and hopefully you'll like it. And if you listen to No Pink Spandex, the podcast that I'm on, and you know my friend Seamus, he said when people ask him, you know, what's the best season of Power Rangers, he legitimately answers Voltron. And I think that's honestly a fair thing to say, because Voltron does have a lot of the characteristics of Power Rangers, but the characters are deeper, the story is larger, and there's just a whole lot more to it. So honestly, if you are a Power Rangers fan, I really do recommend Voltron Legendary Defenders. And again, it's on Netflix, so, you know, even if you're not like a Netflix subscriber regularly, for 10 bucks, you could watch two seasons of Voltron. That's 26 episodes. That's not too shabby. You could easily polish that off in a 1 month subscription. So at least give it a chance, guys. But anyway, I'm going to start opening these up. We're going to start with the Red Lion. We're going to start here with Keith. One of the cool things about these toys is it shows in the back that every single toy comes with a little speeder that has the actual pilot inside of it. So that's a nice little bonus. And they each have like a giant weapon. And again, it does combine. And as you can see on the back of this one, it actually says that if you get the Green Lion and the Red Lion, you get what you need to form the Voltron sword. So that's another little bonus thing there. So let's open this bad boy up. Let's see what we got. This might take a little while, guys, but I think it's going to be worth it. I'm just using a razor blade to cut it along because it's one smooth piece of plastic attached to the box. And again, I'm the type of person that likes to keep the box as nice and pristine as possible. And again, your mileage may vary. You might just rip it off, and that's cool too. But you know, I like to keep things nice. Let's see. That's where you cut the bottom. The bottom's actually attached to the back, so it'll be easier to cut here. Actually, it might be easier just go on the side here. Ooh, and these toys are done by Playmates. I love Playmates, because as a kid, you know, that's where I'd get all my Ninja Turtles. I don't think I bought anything really from Playmates since I was a kid with Ninja Turtles. So, let's see how their quality's showing up. And there's your car, just a pretty simple blue background. Alright, what do we have inside? We have a little booklet. Advertising the show and advertising some of the toys you can get. Okay, so there is actually a big version of Voltron called Ultimate Voltron where it doesn't combine, but it has a lot of different sounds, which is a pretty common thing. So it's a small, it's a lighter price point, but you don't get the combining features. And the basic action figures, all they have right now are the five lions, two different versions of Voltron, and then one Robeast. This one is called Mizak from season one. But again, they're actually going to release the pilots. I'm not going to be buying these action figure versions. They're not really for me. But the five pilots, when they come out in the second wave, I'll definitely be on top of that. And you can get some of the gear and some helmets at the of Voltron. So you get some more sound effect play features there. And of course, the big bad that we have right now. So that's cool. Now let's see what else we got. This is our little instruction manual for the Red Lion. It just shows how the missiles fire in the back, and then how it combines to Voltron. Pretty simple instructions. Probably won't really need those very much. Little card. I tend to keep these as well. There's that. All right, let's see what we got here. Got a missile. And I also tend to bring tweezers for little snips that need to be made. That tends to be easier for the cannon. Boy, they really it's really tight in there. Oh, there's one on his leg too. See, they really packaged in tight. It's Red Lion. Let me snip this out here to get the sword. And the speeder is attached to the sword. Boy, you're not making this easy for me. And there's your giant sword. Very cool. Half of it, obviously. Let's see, how about this little speeder? Boy, this is really in there on this plastic. It is very, I mean, they said it was small and they were not kidding. It is a tiny little bugger. Come on, Daddy. Hopefully once we open one, the rest will be easier because we have a little experience. So yeah, I mean, it says that Keith is in there. But really, it's just a little black body. It's not very impressive. Hold on, I'll try to bring it up to you. Give you a little bit of a better view of what we're working with here. Yeah, it doesn't really want to focus very well, but it's a pretty small little deal. You know, not much to talk about there in that respect. But I still think it's a pretty cool thing. Here, I'm going to move you guys a little bit closer. Get more intimate with me. Yes. Again, that's your one-shot video. So yeah, these are just a fun little bonus. Probably gonna have to put them in, I like little things like this, I tend to put them in a Ziploc baggie, just because I don't wanna lose them. And I know, and I, if you were anything like me, when I was a kid, a lot of those little pieces I did lose. Okay, so we got this. Got the missile that goes in there. And you know, it's just a simple, holy crap, that shot far. Come back to me, missile! Don't you fall under my fridge. Don't you do it. Don't you do it. All right, I got it. And I need to clean under the fridge. That's another bonus thing I just told you guys. But yeah, put the missile back in there. Simply attaches on the back. Not a lot to that, but that's cool. Let's see, the jaw opens. Oh, and it snaps back too. That's pretty nice. Foldable arms have a couple of points of articulation for the legs, which obviously they're going to need to combine into Voltron. His tail kind of comes out, goes in. Obviously, he'll need to do that for Voltron as well. But it's a pretty hefty little piece. It's not as big as the Zords for the big movie Megazord for Power Rangers that I showed you, but it's pretty sizable. You know, it's got a decent amount of heft to it. So yeah, that's our Red Lion. Pretty cool. Nice. All right, and we'll set him there for now. And we'll set this there for now. Again, probably don't really need these instructions, but I'll set that aside. Who do we want to go with next? You know what? Let's stay with the arms. And let's go with Pidge. Little Pidge. There's some spoilers about Pidge if you haven't watched the show yet, so I'm not going to say it. But Pidge does have an interesting storyline in Season 1 that does carry over into Season 2. It isn't explored a lot in Season 2, but it is nice to see all these different characters actually have storylines to them that do need to be followed through. And I would say Pidge is one of the more explored characters. Not to say that the other characters aren't explored. They all definitely have distinctive personalities, which can be a problem for some of these shows, like these Power Rangers and what have you. But overall, Voltron definitely does a very good job of giving its characters personalities and playing them throughout the show. Again, same sort of stuff, same sort of bonuses. Pidge also has a missile, slightly different shape than Keith's. Kind of more of a twisty one, but different shape in his own right. There's the Pidge speeder. Must be careful. All right, got the Pidge speeder. Let me look at the. Okay, they actually are noticeably different designs. They still have the same sort of black portion with just a normal figure, but they actually, you can tell, have slightly different designs. So they're not just all recolors. That's a cool thing. I like the individuality. All right, big snap. Other big snap, there's his cannon. Let's see, well, tied down on the leg as well. And tied down over here. All right, got the green line out. And got his sword. All right. So we're gonna combine and make the giant sword. That should be fun. There's a little indent here and a little indent here, so you know where it goes. Let's see how this hooks together. Yeah, tiny little indents make it pretty easy to combine. There. So as long as you follow these little bumps, you too can form your giant Voltron sword. Mine's kind of smudged, but it's okay. Giant Voltron sword. And again, same difference here where you just put the little missile in. Yep. And then the difference with him, of course, is that he has the shield of Voltron on his back. Let's see, how do they want me to put this on? Do they want me to remove the shield with the cannon on? I believe they do. Yep, that's the thing with Pidges, is he either has the shield on the back or he has the cannon on the back. Oh, and I didn't notice this the first time, but there actually is a little spot to on the bottom here, you can see, the chest that opens up. And I believe, is that the connector? Oh, no, so sorry, that's part for the connecting, but there's one on the back, actually kind of on the taint, kind of on the grundly area. Let me see. Is that what this is, or is that the connector? Nope, that's the connector. Hold on. Because there's supposed to be a spot. Oh no, it was the first place I opened. My bad. But yeah, this place you're supposed to open here, and then you can just take the speeder, and he's supposed to just chill in here. Why'd I grab the green one? So he's just supposed to chill in here. All right, that's cool. Same thing with pitch. Come on. Pop open. Chill your speeder in here. All right, fold the legs down. I actually prefer him with the shield on, but I'll take it off just to show you what he's got. Put the cannon on the back. Boom, boom. Green Lion joins the fleet. All right, next up, we will move on to Lance. Lance is the comic relief of the group, you know? He's the guy who's always like, hey, I'm looking for the ladies. I think every team kind of has that sort of character. A lot of them do. You know, Power Rangers Dino Thunder had that with Chase. If you watch that. And Lance is a similar beast. But again, he's a very funny guy. His main thing is that, okay, so Keith is... I can't say a lot about Keith, because Keith has a very big storyline of his own. And if I go into that, that kind of does give away spoilers. But he's one of the... Keith is kind of more the broody guy trying to figure out stuff about himself. While Lance is the guy who is trying to prove himself. All the while, he's trying to not be super jealous of Keith. Because he's like, oh, Keith's so cool. Keith knows everything. Blah, blah, blah. And he doesn't want to admit it that he feels inferior to Keith. And that's not an uncommon type of storyline in these type of shows. But I think they play it very well. And the difference here is that when Lance tries to be funny, or at least when they're trying to play jokes for his character, they tend to hit. And I think that's one of the big things about Voltron in general. And it was one of the big things about, you know, the other shows these people worked on, the Avatar and Korra, is that it was a cartoon. Yes, it was supposed to be supposedly a kid's show. But the difference was that when it would make jokes, they weren't just jokes about, you know, poop and farting, which, don't get me wrong, some of those jokes do exist, and some of those jokes can be funny, but, you know, usually those jokes aren't funny to people, you know, my age that are watching these shows. And here, they actually are, usually. And that's a big deal. And I tend to like Lance, too, you know. I've always liked that sort of character, with the machismo. At least if you can show that they have a vulnerable side. And that the machismo, they understand, even though they don't want to admit it, that they might feel inferior. And again, we'll put his little speeder in the bottom. Let's see how he attaches his thing. It's funny, I kept telling you I wasn't going to look at these, but I'm looking at them all. Just kind of goes on the sides. Just kind of hangs on there. Doesn't really... Oh, yep. There's little clips there. So, man, he's got a big old giant cannon. This is pretty sweet. I like Keith's. He's got a very cool one. Not Keith's. Lance. Sorry. But again, all these figures, they got the snapping jaws. They got the head that moves. And they have a couple, you know... ball joints here, here, and here. So there's a lot of maneuverability here for these lions. And now we're going to go into the fourth and final of the basic lions. We have our boy Hunk here. Hunk, I was talking about this with my friends earlier. I feel like Hunk is the least developed of the main cast, but I also feel like he's still one of the more fun characters. Hunk is definitely another comic relief person, and if you used to watch old school Super Sentai back in the day, he kind of follows one of the old tropes. It doesn't really exist anymore because there aren't a lot of male Yellow Rangers anymore, but he follows the trope of being the big guy who ends up being the yellow one, and he's very obsessed with like food. That's his big thing. And yes, Hunk has a lot of different food puns, stories, whatever have you. You know, he relates back to food a lot, which can be a little like, okay, I get it, sort of deal. But he's a very fun character overall. If you can get past that whole dumb food obsession deal, though, he's definitely a lot of fun. Let's see. Okay. So it looks like he's a little different in the sense that he doesn't have just a big old missile. He has an actual projector here. Kind of reminds me of, if you ever got, were into the old Ninja Turtles back in the late 80s, early 90s. It's like the pizza thrower sort of deal. Let's see if this works. I'm going to just put one in. It'll be easier if I just try to put one in. Oh! Wow! Yeah, it does work. Alright. So we put all these in. You got a little flying disc. Another thing you'll notice is that two of the arms definitely have a smaller bulk size than the two that are the legs. That's one thing I've noticed. Let's see. Oh, his tail's even in. Let's see. Okay. Boy, you are in good, Hunk. I think you're the most tightly secure guy so far. As far as your packaging goes with your lion. A lot of extra clips for you. Not sure why. Oh, there's a midsection one too. Got it over here. Plop. And we gotta get the yellow speeder out as well. Okay. Alright, there we go. Get all that packaging out of the way. Let's see. Put your little speeder in there. He's got a kind of little, got little loops on his. But there we go. Plop out your legs. Get ready to go, yellow. And pop. Hangs right on the back. So there are your four main lions. Let's try to give them a little room so we can move on to our main course. Also, I think it's kind of cool that they put the sword with these two, because then it kind of makes up for the fact that they aren't as big as these other ones. And the shield, of course. So that's a pretty neat little addition. Now, what we have here is our main course. This is Shiro with the black lion. And cool things on the box here I'm going to see. Right, it says unlock 50 phrases, 50 plus phrases and sound effects. And there's a try me button. Let's see what we got here.
We will save the universe. Let's light this thing up.
Yeah.
Fire lasers. Now we go on the offensive.
So yeah, I've already pushed the button a handful of times and I haven't heard any repeats yet. So that's always a good sign. But again, just awesome. Black lion, there's a lot more to it. He has other phrases like red, green, blue, black, yellow lions, detected, Voltron operational, Voltron combination complete, targeting Robeast, we will save the universe. Lots of just cool stuff. And it says 25 plus points of articulation. So, man, there's a lot here. And price-wise, he should be almost twice as good as any one of these lions. So, let's hope so. And hey, once we get home open, we can actually form Voltron. Yeah. All right. Pop open the top. Probably want to get his instructions out because they'll be the most important to actually form everything. Plop that over to the side. A lot of fun connectors on the back here. This is going to take a minute. Slice. How I do it is I just tend to slice around the tape because I'd rather just pull the whole plastic piece off and then work from there. Again, how you do it might be slightly different, but in my experiences with giant toys like this that are really stuck in there, this is the best way to do it. Especially when you got these friggin' zip ties, man. Zip ties are no joke. There we go. There's one. This is really in there. And this is the least fun part of the video, where you just have to sit here and watch a 32-year-old man try to rip open a toy like it is the most important thing that has ever happened in his life. Which, as a single 32-year-old man, ladies, call me, it might be one of the more exciting things that has happened in my life. Sad face. Sam reacts only. Boom! Got that out. Blamzo. And yes, I'm gonna have to clean a lot of stuff up after this video is over. Alright. Let's start small. And retrieve Chiro Speeder. Ta-da! Alright, next up, what is going to be easy to, that's the question. How many of these do I need to clip before I can finally start to move this bad boy? More than that. More than that. Oh. Still more than that. Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Oh, there's an extra zip here!
Assemble Voltron and get rid of these Golrun!
Holy crap, that scared me. That legit, I was legit shook. People, legit shook. You could see it on my face, hopefully. Well, not hopefully. But, well, you know what I'm saying. Oh my gosh. This one is so hard. Well, now it's just attached to him. Uh-huh. Got rid of that. All right. Don't need you. Anything else here? These little stringies. Ow. That hurt. These things are snapping me, fools. Snapping me. All right. Come on. So many little plasticies. Why do you hate me? What did I ever do to you, Chiro? You angsty guy with your anime hair. Come on. Son of a bitch. Okay. What the heck? Okay, oh, okay, I got it. That was weird. I thought he was missing a leg for a second there, but it's folded in. I was like, what the heck? How does it fold out, though, is the question. Oh, pop that open. Okay, boy, that was very odd. You really confused me for a second there, Black Lion. Alright. Okay. Here we go. Everything is on. Oh, good, there's an off button. So I can turn him off for half a second. That'll be fantastic. Good. All right, here we go. Black Lion is out. Opening the instruction. I don't need my little blades anymore. I can finally get down to business. He takes 3 AAA batteries. If you're ever interested, if you ever need to replace things, and then his middle also opens, I believe. Okay, it's slide open to the side. But there is room to put his little speeder in as well, in the stomach there. There. Okay. Alright. So now we have our entire Voltron team. Drink that in for a second as you check them all out. All together, all ready to go. And you know what that means? It's time to form Voltron. I'm not going to do the thing because I don't know, like, the different, like, form, arms, form, no. Okay, put the legs down. Looks like in the legs, you're really just folding them out. There. Like that. So it looks like it's going to be a pretty typical conversion for any sort of Megazord from Power Rangers. Let's see. Got the leg folded back. And the arms. Okay, so. Like they were just a second ago, you're supposed to, let's see. Okay. So really you're just trying to pop the legs in these little cases there. And that's the biggest thing there. Let's see. With the head. So then the mouth folds down. The neck actually does have quite a bit of a poseability to it. And yes, I'm forming the whole head face thing before I even put the rest on. Whatevs. How does this fold out though? That's my question. Is. Looks like the little horns, I need to try to pop them out, but they're kind of stuck in there pretty good. Yeah, they are. So, I guess that's a demerit. And I just cut myself. Yes, I'm chewing on a toy. This is what I've come to. This is what I've come to form Voltron. Boom. I'll turn it back on. Because I've heard
Voltron is the only thing that can stop Zarkon.
It is. It's true. So this is the Black Lion transformed. Pretty simple, obviously. Now I've been told that he actually recognizes the pieces as they're put on. So we're gonna see exactly how that works. Whatever one we grab next is the one we're gonna do. Okay, Yellow Lion. Boom. Obviously, you can't. These are the shooters. You can't really have them on. So I'll pop him in there. Oh my gosh. I actually just got blood on the toy. Yes, this is a complete and massive, nonsense going on right now. And I'm actually going to pause in the middle of the video to go get myself a Band-Aid because I am that much of a complete and utter screw-up that this is necessary. This is actually necessary. So I'm going to keep talking to you as I sit in the bathroom here trying to grab a Band-Aid and not make this video go on forever and ever. That's the goal. That's the dream, people. You gotta have a dream. You gotta believe. But so that's what we're doing right now. Put a Band-Aid on, like so. Cleaning blood off her hand. Because again, we're an idiot. And we is obviously the royal we, because we're talking about Jeremy and Jeremy alone. But we're good. Alright, that'll work. So pretending none of that ever happened. So the legs go up. Oh, wait. All right, so the legs go in. And then the whole thing folds down. Honestly, this is kind of instinctive. There isn't a lot of actual folding for this sort of mecha. You kind of just assume. Let's see. Let's see. This the that part goes up. And I'm actually gonna cheat and keep the box here off to the side so I can look and see if what I'm making looks like what they've made. And so far, so good. Yep, that is definitely a yellow lion leg as compared to what is on the box. All right, so let's see if this works, if it makes a noise or does something crazy. Hold on. Press the button to release from Black Lion. Okay, so there's it kind of like folds in. Like there's a little like trap door sort of deal. So, let's try this.
Whatever you say, Hero.
Okay, so that was actually Hunk's voice actor talking there. So you can tell that he recognized that the leg is attached. Comparing it to the box, I really think it's doing what it's supposed to. Except in the box, you know, you can't really see the tail standing there, but I think that's just because they kind of, the way they designed it to make it look like that, they wanted to make it look a little more seamless than it actually is. But yeah, you can see the tail there. Now, so that is Hunk, and we are going to move on to... No, we want the other leg, actually. All right, so we are going to move on to a boy, Lance. Take his thing off. Should be very similar transformation. Obviously, you know, you put the little legs up. Fold it down, as so. Kind of move the head thing forward so you can pop up his lion head. And then boom, just popping the legs into position. Very simple, very intuitive, and pop him in, and let's, here we go.
Blue Lion, great for action.
All right, see, it's working. That is definitely.
Mitch, fire up the Green Lion, we're coming in hot.
Oh, so it kind of sounds like you're on like course. Are you, maybe that was coincidental, I'm not sure. But it's kind of like you're saying, all right, we're ready for the next lion.
We need the red lion.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely ready. They know that green and red need to come on. Honestly, one thing I will say is that it doesn't seem like it's standing very well. You really have to get the lion feet in perfect position in order for him to stand up and stay standing up. But again, that's a pretty cool feature. All right, let's move on to Pidge. Our first attempt to include in the arms. I'll put a shield back on, like so. And let's see what it says. Obviously, a tail goes in. That's a no-brainer. Go in. This kind of folds. It looks folds a little bit back a little bit. I want the legs up straight. Okay. Oh, and they fold in. All right. Like so. I think you kind of need to take this out for the arms, because you really need all that space inside to put the legs in. All right, and that kind of, and that folds right back in. And then there's a little piece right here that folds out, and this is the connector. So, time for the Green Lion.
Pitch, fire up the Green Lion.
I heard you.
Coming in hot.
I heard you. So is there a certain... There. Okay.
We need the Red Lion! We need the Red Lion!
Okay, so yep. That told you that you got green in. Sorry, I gotta show you guys. There we go. Green Lion is attached. Nice enough. Which means we are down to our final lion. Alright, same sort of thing. I'm gonna take... Oh, he disappeared in there. Oh well, get it later. Legs fold up and in. Back opens. Get out of there, little speeder man. Speeder man does whatever a speeder can. Alright, legs fold up. Gotta put them in there. Yeah. Come on. There we go. Alright. Legs are insecure. Put it down. Stay in their tail. I guess that's one of the few negatives is that the tails don't really seem like they want to fully stay in. But, you know, so be it. And our final arm attachment. Let's see. Is that not the right way? Nice little combination. It also looks like the wings. Let's see. Oh, okay. So the back wings can fold out. What's the proper way to fold them out? Looks like you can go all the way up with them. It's kind of like the default way. So put them all the way up in the sky. And then, of course...
Great! Blue Lion, ready for action!
Okay,
Lion,
nope.
Ready for...
I don't want to hear that again. But you can just... There you go. You can pop open the little lion mouth. Put the sword in hand. And yes, folks, this is our complete Voltron. I gotta say, I dig it. It's got a lot of size. Again, it says it's supposed to be 16 inches. And I think that's fair. Again, I don't think the feet stand as super as well as I would like them to. The poseability, while it is there, it's kind of like chunky in the sense that when you move it, you can really feel the whole thing move every time you click it. But overall, it's a really, really cool toy. Is it worth like $90 to $100? That's kind of a personal question. It definitely has a lot of heft to it. If you're a fan of the new series, I definitely recommend getting this. I think it really has the good feel of the show. I don't know if they're going to introduce more versions of these, if they're going to redo Voltron. But as it is, as what it is, it's a very, very fun toy. And for me, it was worth the money. I really, really dig it. I think I prefer it with the wings down, actually. I think I'm more into the regular version of Voltron, because it's not popping out the wings. And doesn't necessarily need the sword to be fun in my book. I think it's fun as is, just checking out as a big toy. But overall, yeah, I definitely dig it. I think it's good. I think it's a nice attempt by Playmates to do their own sort of Power Rangers thing. And it's a lot of fun. Again, personal choice if you want to spend the money. If you want to be an idiot like me and cut your finger, that's a different thing entirely. But, you know, that's how it is. And I think that's going to be it for this video. Again, guys, really, if you like Power Rangers, check out Voltron. I can't recommend it highly enough. But that's going to be it for me. I'm Jeremy, aka Captain Subpar, telling you as always, please, just like this video if you like it. comment if you have something you'd like to say. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't subscribed before. Ring that bell, please, to get informed of my new videos. And the best thing you can do for me is to share this video with your friends, your family, people who are Power Rangers fans, Voltron fans, people who just like really good animation and good storytelling. Honestly, that above all else. Please, just watch Voltron. I beg of you, it's such a good show. I will be back very soon with some more unboxing videos. I don't know what's coming up next, probably some more loot crates. The new Super Sentai Q Ranger toys have not gone on pre-sale yet for me, but I'm sure they'll be here sooner than later, probably within the next month. So that'll be fun. That'll be some more interesting stuff to do. Until then, again, as always, Jeremy, aka Captain Subpar, I've said that multiple times in this video, still friggin' true, saying, as always, I am going to be King of the Geeks. Say something else, Voltron. Speak to him. Give him a sermon. What do you got to say?
Wow.
Pitch. Form shield.
My shield can't take much more of this.
Oh, the shield, it can't take much more, Captain. That's a Star Trek reference, right? I don't watch Star Trek. I don't know.